Often people think that multiplying by 9 is difficult, but it's actually one of the easiest numbers to multiply by. In fact, you can use your fingers to multiply 9 times any single digit, like 9 times 2, 9 times 3, etc. So one way of doing this is putting your hands out about 1 foot in front of you with your palms facing toward you. So your thumbs are on the outside and your little fingers are in the middle next to each other. To multiply 9 times 3, you would put your third finger down. So I'm sort of illustrating this as best I can, and you can see why I was a math major, not an art major. But here's your third finger down, I'm sort of showing in red. And what this does is this breaks your fingers up. So you started off with 10 fingers up, and now you put that third finger down. You're counting from the left, third finger. So there's two fingers here, and here's the finger that's down, right? And then you've got seven fingers left. So you've got two fingers to the left of your third finger, seven fingers to the right of your third finger, and that's 9 times 3, 27. There you go. So that's how you can use your fingers to do 9 times any single digit. All right, so try this with your hands. Put your hands out in front of you, and let's do 9 times 6 and see how you do. So you're going to do 9 times 6, and I'm going to draw a little picture of it. Okay, so on the left hand, you don't do anything with those 5 fingers, but here's the 6th finger right here in red. So there are going to be 5 fingers up until that finger that you put down, and then there's 4 fingers to the right. So 9 times 6 is 54. And there you go. You could practice that. 9 times 2, 9 times 3, 9 times 4, 9 times 7, 9 times 9. It's going to work. Another thing that's very interesting to note here is that in your answer, 9 times 3, we get the answer of 27. We have the digits 2 and 7. Those should add up to 9 because you're really only counting 9 fingers since you put one finger down. So assuming you have all 10 fingers and you put one finger down that you're not counting, there's only going to be 9 fingers left to count. So same thing here, 9 times 6 is 54. 5 and 4 add up to 9. And that'll work with any number. 9 times any single digit, the answer, those two digits will add up to 9. Now, there are other ways of figuring out how to multiply by 9 without using your fingers at all. So think about if you had all the single digits 9 times 1, 9 times 2, all the way up to 9 times 9. Go ahead and write those out and see if you can see a pattern. Okay, I'm not going to do 9 times 1 to begin with, but 9 times 2 is 18, and then 9 times 3 is 27, 9 times 4 is 36. What's happening? If you look at the digit on the left, it's going 1, 2, 3, it's going to go right up the line, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then going backwards, starting at the bottom, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the 9 times 1 is 9. Usually you write the 9 over here, but if you want, you could note that that's the same thing as 0, 9. So it still goes up all the way up to 9 here. So here, you don't usually write the 0, but you can see if it starts from 0 to 8, and then it goes all the way from 1 to 9. So there's a pattern that you should see developing here. And notice that all the digits again add up to 9 for the answers. 8 and 1 is 9, 7 and 2 is 9, 6 and 3 is 9, etc. Okay, another pattern to notice. When you're doing 9 times 7, just look at what's happening here when I'm doing 9 times 7. Notice that when you're doing 9 times 7, the first digit is 6. That's one less than 7, right? So if you're doing 9 times 7, the first digit has to be 6. And then the other number has to be whatever makes it add up to 9. So 6 plus 3 makes it add up to 9. If you're doing 9 times 4, one digit less than 4 is 3. And then 3 plus what adds up to 9? 6. So if you're going to do use this idea and you're trying to do 9 times 8, you would say, well, I have to go one digit below the 8, one less than that is 7, and then 7 plus what adds up to 9, because the digits always add up to 9. You get 72. So there's another way of doing it without using your fingers, noticing the pattern here. So it's always one less than that to begin with, and then the other number, whatever makes it add up to 9. Okay, now there's some more fun stuff. A lot of people already know how to do single digits times 9, but what if they're bigger numbers? All right, here are a couple of examples, and notice what I'm doing is multiplying 9 times a two-digit number, but the digits are exactly the same. So 44, 88, and this pattern will work for times 22, times 33, etc. So if you do 9 times 44 on your calculator or by hand, you should get 396. If you do 9 times 88, you get 7 times 90, 792. Here's the pattern. All right. If you first just think of the 9 times 4, you get 36. Do you see that 9 times 4? There's your 36. And we do 9 times 8, you get 72. Well, there's your 72. But what happened is this extra single digit left over goes in the middle. So there's going to be a 9 in the middle. So when you have a two-digit number, it's got to have a 9 in the middle. So let's see, what would it be if I had 9 times 33? Well, 9 times 3 is 27, isn't it? And for this extra 3, you get a 9 in the middle. Pretty cool? All right, what's it going to be for 9 times 77? See if you could do that one. Okay, do you notice there's going to be a 9 in the middle? And 9 times 7 is 63. So you get 693. Okay, so that's pretty cool. You could do that in your head, right? You can go to people and say, hey, could you do 9 times 88 as fast as I can? And then you could go right for it, 792. All right, we could make it slightly more complicated, but it's actually really easy. Check this pattern out. Okay, see if you could figure out the pattern. Again, I'm multiplying 9 by some number that has the same digit. Okay, so I have 9 times 3,333, 9 times 444, and 9 times 666,666. See if you could figure out the pattern before I give it away. Okay, here it is. Does anybody notice, like, if you kind of just check out the 9 times 3, you see that 27 over here? And 9 times 4, see the 36? And 9 times 6, see the 54? But then what? Well, we've got some extra 3's here, right? How many? I've got 3 extras. That's how many 9's go in the middle. So I have 3 9's in the middle. Here I've got 2 extra 4's, 2 9's in the middle. I've got 5 extra 6's, 5 9's go in the middle. So if you're doing 9 times a 6-digit number, you'll end up with 5 9's in the middle. If you're doing it by a 3-digit number, you'll have 2 9's in the middle. And of course, this only works if all the digits are exactly the same. All right, so how about trying this one? 9 times 88,888. See if you could write down what that equals without getting out your calculator. You could always get out a calculator and check it. Well, let's see. 9 times 8 is going to be 72. I'm going to put the 9's in the middle first so I have room. How many 9's am I going to have to put in the middle? Well, I've got 4 extra digits here of the 8, so I'm going to have 4 9's in the middle. 4 9's in the middle, and then my 9 times 8 is 72. And there you go. So, like I said, very cool. Very cool. So, here's how kids could have fun with this, or adults. You can go up to somebody and on an index card, make a whole bunch of them like this, like 9 times 888, 9 times 88, 9 times 999, 9 times 66666, and then, you know, at your next party, you just give it to somebody and say, you can get the answer the fastest, and you're going to be that one. You're going to be able to do it without a calculator, without a piece of paper at all. So have a great time and teach it to somebody else.